Hello, fellow geek bikers, and welcome to Geekbike episode 6. As you can see, I'm in my Geekbike lair next to our gray Subarus, which we're apparently obsessed with. Today's video is going to talk about something that is not well understood by many people, and that is the subject of flop. Flop is a characteristic of steering geometry in bicycles that tends to produce unwanted or promotes undesired or unwanted turning of the handlebars in a sense on its own without necessarily being the direct input of the rider. Flop is interrelated to trail somewhat, and in short, even though this video is going to only show sort of more explicitly the effects of flop, we have to keep in mind that trail is also playing a role here. And if you have no idea what these terms mean, I'm going to put in the description of this video a link to a blog post of mine, which gets into what these things are and the forces that they produce on the steering. But for now, I'm just going to show with two different bikes I have different flop characteristics. So I've got my P38 here, okay, and I've got the Zevo. All right, these two bikes have the least amount of flop in the case of the Zevo, and most amount of flop of any current bikes that I own, especially recumbent bikes. But the P38 even out flops my cyclocross bike, which is a little bit got a problem with that too. So what am I going to show you? Well, let me just show you. So I'm just steering the bike from behind. I'm just pushing it, okay? And don't think I'm trying to pull any tricks here. This is just going to be how it goes, all right? There's no subtle turning of the seat that trying to make it steer one way or the other. We're just going to show it. So I'm going to just try to push it straight. Oh, do you see how it's turning? I did not intend to do that. I was trying to hold the bike just straight up and down, and I must have been leaning it very slightly, or maybe there was an imperfection in the concrete of my floor, which of course that exists. There's pock marks and little bits of gravel and that sort of thing that's crumbling that made the bars turn. And as I'm standing here without trying, the handlebars just want to flop over. Okay, so let's try it again. Maybe I'll get a little further this next time. Okay, see, I've got it angled already, and I'm just trying to get it straight. Okay, there we go. So even trying to get it straight is tricky. Okay, I did it again. So when I try to get it straight just by riding the bike and kind of pushing it the other way, it just tends to flop around. Again, it's just wanting to go to the right. I honestly don't know if I'm steering it that way or not. Honestly, I'm not trying to. Okay, maybe you're getting the point here. The steering is extremely sensitive, and I'm trying to just advance it forward, but it just keeps wanting to turn. And it's prone in both directions here. I was thinking maybe there was some slope in the floor, and that's why it was going right. But it's also going the other direction. Okay, so maybe you're getting the point already. That's flop. Flop is produced by the fact that the front of the bike, as you turn the handlebars, the front of the bike actually goes downward. It actually gets closer to the ground. And when you turn it back straight again, the front of the bike actually raises up. So gravity is acting as a force to want to bring it down. Try this with your own bike, especially if your bike's got a slack head tube angle. It's pretty evident. You can actually see it. I don't think this really renders in this video here. I don't have a tripod and other things very carefully controlling it, but it does drop when you turn the bar. So that's what's producing the flop. That's the force at work. If you're hearing some noise in the background, that's because a thunderstorm just erupted. Okay, let me put this bike to the side. Sorry for the horrendous filming. Okay, let's try it with the Zevo. Well, how is the Zevo different? It has a very steep head angle, okay? So that angle relative to the ground is pretty upright. It's not 90 degrees, it's 85. So it's 5 degrees laid back. The head tube angle on the our steering angle on the P38 is about 70 degrees, which is fairly typical for a lot of recumbents. And this bike has a reverse rake fork to keep trail pretty normal. This bike has about 70 millimeters of trail. That's a little higher than average. Average is probably 55, 60 on most recumbents, maybe even 65. But most critically, that's done with much slacker head tubes, you know, 70, 71, that sort of thing. Sometimes even slacker. I know some recumbents that I've measured at 68 and 69 degrees, which I'll just tell you right now, I think that's way too slack. But anyway, that's what's used. So let's look how this bike behaves with respect to flop. See how it's different. Okay. So I'm just going to do the same thing. I'll try to get the steering perfectly straight here. Okay. Pretty good. I'm having trouble shaking it into position. Doesn't really want to move. That's actually a measurement of what we're talking about. Okay, moving forward. I don't have any trouble doing that. It just tends to, even going backwards, it just stays where it's at. That would have flopped around horribly. I should have shown you that, the P38. If you go backwards, it's even worse. But yeah, just doing it again, not even trying. It just kind of stays straight. Now, what's interesting here, if I go ahead and I lean it, you can see it starts to turn, right? So now I've got a bike that's got the handlebars turned. If I just go straight, it just kind of self-corrects. You see what's happening there? That's actually trail pulling it back into center. So on this bike, I have very little flop and a pretty large amount of trail. So what that means is it basically doesn't want to turn on its own. You know, it's expecting input from the rider. And that's how it feels in practice. This bike you have to steer. It doesn't just flop into the turn. It just, when the bike leans, you have to basically steer it. You have to, you know, push on the bars, turn the bars. It's not hard to do. No way does it fight you from turning. But it, again, it's just not going to do it on its own. It needs the steering input all the way. A little bit like driving a car or riding a trike in that respect. You have to actually steer it at all times. A bike with a lot of flop, once it goes into the turn, the steering kind of flops. It actually, in a way, is almost like power steering to steer you into the turn. In that specific context, it actually, flop is fine, feels fine. But the general issue with flop is when you're not intending to turn, it has a tendency to make you flop all over the road. And I'm using flop in a slightly different sense there, I guess. Wobble, maybe, is the right term to say. Wobble all over the road. So again, it just, it's stable, basically. Again, I'm not going to get into the exact how you calculate flop and how you calculate trail, but I don't calculate it by hand anyway. I have a link to a calculator in the article that's in the description. And read that and watch this video and play around with your own bikes. Try to figure out what the flop and trail of each of your bikes are and do the simple experiment. And I think you'll find that the bikes that have lower flop measurements will be easier to steer, especially if the trail to flop ratio is reasonably high, say 4 or greater. If you have a bike with lots of flop or a trail flop ratio, say 3 or even the high 2s, you'll find it's a handful to try to steer from the seat. So I hope that illustrates something, makes it maybe a little more intuitive for people. That's it for now, geek bikers. See ya.